1 minute. The hell with you, Vince Russo. And send. Welcome to the wrestling show. Wow. Did you see Monday Night Raw, the last 20 minutes? At first I saw Hornswoggle and whatever the heck that was going on. I'm like, I'm going to turn off Raw. But the last 20 minutes definitely made it worthwhile. But before we get into, you know, certain people making their return, or TNA stuff, or any wrestling stuff in general, time to plug my merchandise, Wrestling Bear Mug. Wrestling Bear is the official mascot of the wrestling show. Wrestling Bear is much like Smokey Bear in that he stands for a cause. Smokey Bear says, only you can prevent forest fires. Whereas Wrestling Bear says, only you can prevent unbagging videos. Because nobody wants to see unbagging videos. Wrestling Bear, check that out, little kids that like doing unbaggings. Wrestling Bear is on the hunt. If you start doing an unbagging video, he will break into your house and suplex you, okay? So, I guess that's a good cause. I mean, sure, it kind of promotes violence, but, you know, it's a trade-off. The Wrestling Show hat. Whether you're a trucker or somebody that likes to wear hats. Good stuff. And finally, chicks will dig you in the club and men will be jealous of you. The Wrestling Show t-shirt. All of this comes at a low price without sacrificing quality and can soon be found on WrestlingRevolution.com. Okay, before we get into the Raw, we'll save that more towards the end. Let's talk about Jeff Etch-a-Sketch Hardy. First off, his face looks like a kindergarten art project nowadays. I mean, he's not even trying to be like symmetrical, it's just like someone scribbles on his face. He is the new TNA champ. You know, I'm not even going to bash Jeff Hardy anymore. I'm going to bash the people around him. Look, you're promoting his behavior by giving him the belt and top spots. He is not that big a draw. If Jeff Hardy left, I'm pretty sure the numbers wouldn't go anywhere. And you're just promoting his, whether it's selling of drugs, doing drugs. You know, I'm sure every wrestler get some pain, and maybe they take some painkillers or whatever. That's slightly different than what Jeff Hardy is doing. I mean, he's doing like, well, how would we put it? Okay, are you people familiar with Chex Mix? You know, it's a little bit of everything. Jeff Hardy kind of dabbles in a little bit of everything as far as the drug world. So like drug mix, okay? You know, little needles, little pills, you know, it's all good. It's a party, right? So whether it's wrestlers or agents or management, you think somebody would step in and say, hey, we're not going to fire you, Jeff Hardy, but we probably shouldn't put you at the front runner, you know, seeing how you're a criminal and, yeah. But money talks and, you know, whatever. What else we have? We had something coming up. Oh, yeah, Elimination Chamber. Miz vs. Lawler kind of sounds like a TNA main event, but it's something different. But let's talk about the end of Raw. The Rock returned after 7 years, and supposedly he's going to stay, I guess, for a while. I mean, he made the statement he's not going to leave, so I'm guessing this is at least a few-year deal, where he'll be, I guess, part-time wrestling at least. And his promo was nice. See, a lot of people had made videos in the past, you know, we need cussing, or we need violence, or PG's bad, bring back, you know, the Attitude Era. What I will agree with is the Attitude Era, certain elements need to be. Like, when WWE puts PG on their product, it limits them. Now, I don't want promos with laced, you know, profanity, but if they have to, you know, slip a cuss word in once, you know, go ahead. I don't want them to be like, you know, hands tied behind their back, they can only say, poo-poo head, you know. If they want to say, you know, shat head, then they should go ahead and be able to say that. They shouldn't be handcuffed. So I think Raw should go, you know, like TV-14. But it was nice. I don't know, maybe Rock won't be able to cuss anymore, but for one night, he cussed a few times, you know, that's the way Rock does his promos. Good Rock promo, and are we gonna see Rock vs. Cena? Let's hope so. I mean, I'm pretty sure that Cena's gonna win, But yeah, Rock is hosting WrestleMania 27. They brought him out. And good promo. I mean, I'm kind of speechless, but I don't want to get too giddy because I know a lot of people are going to overanalyze this and be like, Rock saved wrestling. And, you know, it'll definitely make things interesting. And I'm a fan of The Rock. And I think WWE's not going to bury anyone. They're not going to be like, oh, we're going to forget John Morrison. It's all about The Rock, you know. They're not quite like TNA where they're going to put everything behind The Rock, you know. But Rock will definitely help. You know, interest will turn perhaps back to Raw. And then, you know, people like John Morrison or the other, what they want to call, mid-carders, their great wrestling will get showcased, you know, seen by more viewers. And people will be like, wow. I like this Rock guy, I like this really athletic John Morrison guy, or, you know, who else? Well, I guess SmackDown's got Kofi Kingston, you know, Dolph Ziggler on SmackDown. Basically, Raw and SmackDown are going to benefit, but WWE overall, people are going to look and be like, wow, you know, this Rock guy's kind of cool. Hey, I remember that Edge dude. Like, it's a great nostalgia thing. Nostalgia people will turn back in, the new fans will kind of tune in, the current fans will be like, wow, I never heard about this Rock guy. It's good overall. I mean, I think people are jizzing a little too much about this, but it's a good thing. I was excited. I'm not going to use terms like marked out. Definitely brought nostalgia back. I was like, this is cool. He's cutting on John Cena, and it's all true. So yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I don't have really much more to say. This is going to be interesting. Everyone's going to be tuned in. Made wrestling a little more exciting. Just one man just peaked it a little. This could help out a lot. I'm not gonna say this is the saving grace of wrestling, but definitely a good thing. I'm not gonna overanalyze or anything. Just gonna enjoy it like, you know, I used to. So thank you all for tuning into the wrestling show, and don't forget to tune into Raw because this might be something good. So, thank you all and have a great week. And don't forget to buy Wrestling Show merchandise. Visit WrestlingRevolution.com. Oh, and last thing, D. Jose, you and Grumpy Cheeto's videos put me to sleep. So, heard you're going to be leaving after WrestleMania, which is a good thing because your videos put me to sleep. So, if you want to be famous, you could probably ditch your partner, you know, Grumpy Cheeto over there, and go one-on-one with, I guess me. I'm not really the great one. But next month is Block History Month, in which I will inform all you fans, and haters, I guess, of the greatness that is Block. I will tell you my life history and all my accomplishments, which, unlike most of you people, isn't just, you know, I make YouTube videos. No, I have accomplishment after accomplishment. I've done things with my life. So, yeah. D. Jose, be jealous. And hopefully I will get to whip your beep. Oh, wait. We can cuss. I'm going to whoop your ass at WrestleMania. But whether it's you one-on-one, or me and Zamario versus you and Grumpy Cheeto, the end result will be the same. So catch all of you next week.